black sand. That's it.
Thank you.
The first lesson is written in the book of the prophet Ezekiel, the third chapter, beginning at the fourth verse. The Lord God said to me, "Mortal, go to the house of Israel and speak my very words to them. For you are not sent to a people of obscure speech and difficult language, but to the house of Israel, not to many peoples of obscure speech and difficult language, whose words you cannot understand. Surely, if I sent you to them, they would listen to you. But the house of Israel will not listen to you, for they are not willing to listen to me, because all the house of Israel have a hard forehead and a stubborn heart. See, they have made your face hard against their faces, and your forehead hard against their foreheads. Like the hardest stone, harder than flint, I have made your forehead. Do not fear them or be dismayed at their looks, for they are a rebellious house." He said to me, "Mortal, all my words that I speak to you, receive in your heart and hear with your ears. Then go to the exiles, to your people, and speak to them. Say to them, 'Thus says the Lord God,' whether they hear or refuse to hear." Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
The second lesson is written in the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians, the first chapter beginning at the 13th verse. You've heard, no doubt, of my earlier life in Judaism. I was violently persecuting the Church of God and was trying to destroy it. I advanced in Judaism beyond many among my people of the same age, for I was far more zealous for the traditions of my ancestors. But when God, who had set me apart before I was born and called me through his grace, was pleased to reveal his Son to me, so that I might proclaim him among the Gentiles, I did not confer with any human being, nor did I go up to Jerusalem to those who were already apostles before me. But I went away at once into Arabia, and afterwards I returned to Damascus. Then after 3 years, I did go up to Jerusalem to visit Kephas, and stayed with him for 15 days. But I did not see any other apostle except James, the Lord's brother. In what I am writing to you before God, I do not lie. Then I went into the regions of Syria and Cilicia, and I was still unknown by sight to the churches of Judea that are in Christ. They only heard it said, the one who formerly was persecuting us is now proclaiming the faith he once tried to destroy. And they glorify God because of me. Then, after 14 years, I went up again to Jerusalem with Barnabas, taking Titus along with me. I went up in response to a revelation. Then I laid before them, though only in a private meeting with the acknowledged leaders, the gospel that I proclaimed among the Gentiles, in order to make sure that I was not running or had not run in vain. But even Titus, who was with me, was not compelled to be circumcised, though he was a Greek. But because of faithful believers secretly brought in, who slipped in to spy on the freedom we have in Christ Jesus, so that they might enslave us, we did not submit to them even for a moment, so that the truth of the gospel might always remain with you. And from those who were supposed to be acknowledged leaders, what they actually were makes no difference to me. God shows no partiality. Those leaders contributed nothing to me. On the contrary, when they saw that I had been entrusted with the gospel for the uncircumcised, just as Peter had been entrusted with the gospel for the circumcised, for he who worked through Peter, making him apostle to the circumcised, also worked through me in sending me to the Gentiles. Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you.
believe in God,
which is thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holiness is high, works to proceed. Give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be said to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour.
Amen.
Light in our darkness we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
The anthem, with music by Johannes Brahms and words by Paul Fleming, The Geistliches Lied. Do not be sorrowful or regretful. Be calm, as God has ordained.
Thank you.
Surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us make our prayer in the power of the Spirit, looking to Jesus, the pioneer of our faith. On this eve, the great feast day of St. Peter and St. Paul, we give thanks for their leadership within the Church, for their example of faith and their zeal for the gospel. We pray for all those in their line are now leaders of the Church in this, our own generation, for all our bishops across the Church. Praying particularly though at this time for the Archbishop of Canterbury, for the Anglican Communion, and for the Church of the Province of Central Africa and the Diocese of Northern Malawi. Praying for the bishop there, for those who share in the bishop's ministry, and for the people. We pray for Michael, our bishop, for his ministry amongst us, for Clive, Sarah, and Matthew, the area bishops. We pray for all those who minister within this diocese, particularly those who minister within the deanery of Rocquidine. And we pray for this cathedral church. And also in our prayers, we pray for the peace of the world. Praying for the people of Ukraine, for all those who are suffering greatly at this time in the midst of such atrocity and warfare. We pray for those who have lost loved ones, for those who are maimed or injured, for those who have had to flee for their lives. We pray for all those who try to bring about reconciliation and peace. We pray that with the noble fellowship of the prophets, we may discern the signs of your kingdom in our midst. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. That with the glorious company of the apostles, we may proclaim your gospel throughout the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. That with the white-robed army of martyrs, we may be ready to suffer for the truth's sake. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. That with all who are anointed by your Spirit, we may bring good news to the poor and freedom to the oppressed. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. That with the saints in light, we may bind up the brokenhearted and comfort all who mourn. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. That within the whole company of Christ's pilgrim people, we may come to the inheritance of the saints in glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In communion with Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Chad, our patron, St. Peter and Paul, and all the saints, let us commend the world to the mercy and protection of God as we say together the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen.